Okay, hello. Are you guys ready for some physics? Yep, me too. It's a little early, but this is the only time I can make a video. I want to show you how you come up with these kinematic equations. We use them, and you think, oh, you got to use calculus to derive those, and in fact, you don't. Okay. So let's just start with, let me go ahead and say I'm only dealing with one dimension. You can call it the x direction, you can call it whatever. I'll call it x. Okay. So I'm not going to put subscripts on my variables for velocity and acceleration. I'm not going to write vectors. But it does actually work if you did it as a vector equation, too. But I'm not going to do that. Okay, so let's start with the definition of acceleration and the definition of average velocity. So here I have average velocity, v average, is delta x over delta t. That's it. Okay? Because it doesn't matter if it's changing velocity during that time. The average is still delta x over delta t. And then I have the acceleration is delta v over delta t. Now technically, this is the average acceleration. But the kinematic equations only work for cases with constant acceleration, such that the average is the same as the instantaneous. If it's not a constant acceleration, then it's just a tough problem. Okay, so let's not worry about that. So there's another definition. So let me show you what I'm talking about here. Let's talk about if I have a velocity graph and I have an object that starts at it starts from rest and then I let it go and it accelerates, then this is what the graph would look like. Okay, so it's constantly increasing in velocity since it's speeding up with the constant acceleration. Well, how far did it go? In this amount of time, I'll call this t0, and this, let's call that t. Well, during that time, I could actually say, here's my final velocity, I'll call it v2, and here's my initial velocity, v1. Well, it's almost as though it was traveling this constant velocity, an average velocity, v average is v2 plus v1 over 2. Okay. And that's if that's constant, then I can use that, even if it's not. But that is the average velocity. But now I can use that and compare it to this right here, and so I can say delta x over delta t. So here's, I have two definitions for average velocity. I have the change in position over the change in time, and the final plus initial velocity divided by 2. They're the same thing. Okay. Okay. Let me just write this out a little bit, but this is where I'm going to start with. Now, I'm going to say delta t is t2 minus t1, but I'm going to say this is just t. I'm going to call t1 0. Really? No, I'm not. I'm going to leave it as delta t, because that's better. It's a better way to do it. And we should do things the best way ever, okay? We shouldn't take shortcuts. So I'll leave it as delta t. I will call delta x, x2 minus x1. So it starts at x1, it ends in x2. Some books use x initial, x final. I like to call them 1 and 2. You could call them 0 and 1. You could do anything. Just be consistent. That's an x. Okay. So now, let me get started. So I can just rewrite this equation as, I'm going to first multiply by delta t. So I get v2 plus v1 delta t over 2 equals delta x. Okay. So now I can multiply this out. Hold on, wait a second. Where's that going with this? v2, I want to get a in there. Okay, well, let's just start with this equation right here. I should have planned this out beforehand. Let's say delta v equals a delta t. This equation is multiplied both sides by delta t. Okay. So now delta v is going to be v2 minus v1 equals a delta t. No, I'm doing okay. I'm in the right spot. Okay. So, I can go over here. I don't really want the final velocity in my answer. So I'm gonna get rid of that. So I'm gonna add V1 to both sides over here. V2 equals V1 plus A delta T. That's my final velocity. Now I'm gonna put that in over here for V2. Okay. So I still have that 2 over here. So let's just, it looks a little messy, but I'll write it out. Delta X equals V2, which is going to be V1 plus A delta T plus V1. All of that over 2. Delta T. Okay. So now I get 2 V1s. And I'm going to divide that by 2. So that's just going to be V1. Right, V1 plus V1 is 2V1. I have to divide everything in here by 2. And then I get this. Oh, and then I also have to multiply by delta T. And then I have the 1 half A delta T times delta T. Okay, now that's delta X. This is an okay form, but now if I write delta X is X2 minus X1, and solve for X2, I get X2, add X1 to both sides. X2 equals X1 plus V1 delta T plus 1 half A delta T squared. And that is your most important kinematic equation. And it doesn't require calculus, and it comes from just these two definitions plus the definition of average velocity or this way too. This says X, but it works for as long as this is the x acceleration. Okay, I really should say that. It's the x acceleration. And this is the x initial velocity. And this is x. These are all x's. If you wanted to do this in the y direction, it would still work with y2 equals y1 plus v1y delta t plus 1 half ay delta t squared. As long as a is constant. Okay, a has to be constant. Now there is another common kinematic equation. What if I take this and I take take this and I use those to eliminate this one. Solve this for delta t and plug it in here. I'm not going to algebraically do it, but I'll tell you what you get. You get this other kinematic equation, v, and these are all in the x direction, v2 squared equals v1 squared plus 2a x2 minus x1. That's the other common kinematic equation. It's not hard to derive, and there's a better way to derive it later using energy. But this, it just comes from eliminating t. So this one does not have t in the equation, and this one does. Okay. So that those two, along with these, are your kinematic equations. But really, these two are all you really need. So those are the kinematic equations.